Hello students, once again we begin with e-learning of standard 12th, in which we have begin with topic of subject of electronics, in which there are two parts, electronics 1 as well as electronics 2. So here we begin with the chapters of electronics 1, in which we have very first chapter, that is electronic instruments, that we begin with the subject of syllabus of electronics here. So before going to start with the electronic subject, so we have two papers of electronics, electronics 1, electronics 2. The theory of electronics 1 and electronics 2 carry 50 plus 50 means 100 marks theory of paper 1 and paper 2. We have separate papers of electronics 1 as well as electronics 2, and also we have two practicals of electronics 1 as well as electronics 2. So there are two practicals, and including journal and including your project work, we have 50 plus 50 means 100 marks of practical work, 100 marks of theory for total electronics, in which we have two paper, electronics 1 and electronics 2. So in that we have the theoretical part or theory paper carry 50 plus 50. So already sir has explained the marking scheme of paper 1, paper 2 as well as the practicals also. Okay. Now let us begin with the first chapter of electronics 1, that is electronic instruments. So let us check the presentation. Check carefully. So we have begin with the chapter of electronics, paper 1, and first chapter electronic instruments. So what we have, this subtopics. So in this chapter we learn about few advanced and sophisticated laboratory instruments like CRO, function generator, and digital multimeter DMM with illustrations. We should know about a digital component like logic gate, counters, from paper 2 to understand these instruments. So before going to start with this particular syllabus, you should know the basic of electronics. So in that electronics we have the paper 2, logic gates, then counters, that you are going to learn in paper number 2nd. So this will be the three topics. So check carefully, we have the three instruments and laboratory instruments, CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope, and second one function generator, which generate the signals having different frequencies. Then third instrument is a digital multimeter. So one by one we begin with the actual function of these particular three instruments, in which we have very first as cathode ray oscilloscope. So in lab we have the cathode ray oscilloscope, and it is look like this. So this instrument is called cathode ray oscilloscope. It has a display screen, then the channel 1 for input and second channel 2, then this will be displays the Y component of the screen, and the X component is time base, and we have number of keys that will be used or has a specific function. So this will be the cathode ray oscilloscope, which is a sophisticated instrument in which we have to measure number of different quantities, for example voltage of signal, then phase of signal. So like that we have number of physical quantities that can be measured accurately with the help of these oscilloscope. Now that oscilloscope has the number of components, and from that components we have very first component as a cathode ray tube, CRT. So we already know the black and white and color televisions in near about 1975 onwards, we have the television broadcasting, and in that case we have the first black and white televisions, and that black and white televisions I think up to 1990s, so near about 15 to 18 years there is a specific generation we use the black and white televisions, and that black and white televisions has the important component or important part that is called cathode ray tube. Then we have, after 90s, we have the color televisions in India. So that color television also has the cathode ray tube as important part, and that will be display the color image or color video form. So with the help of that electron beam, the particular cathode ray tube display the image in color or black and white form. So the important part in that television is cathode ray tube, and that cathode ray tube is also used in CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. Now check carefully the diagram. Cathode ray tube, CRT, short form is CRT, which has this particular structure. So this is the front side and the back side of this tube. So we have the pin connections for different internal components. So here we have the base of the tube, we have number of connecting pins, keys, and this first part is called electron gun. So this portion is called electron gun of the cathode ray tube. Then second portion is called, up to this, this is called a deflection plate assembly. So this portion is called deflection plate, first combination of pair of plates, and second pair of plates, this particular part is called assembly, deflection plate assembly, and the next part is called the fluorescence screen. So here we have the screen on front side, that's it. So in that we have number of small components. So we have very first in electron gun assembly, here we have the filament, then cathode, and then we have the control grid, then we have the anode, that is called pre-accelerating anode, then focusing anode in between them, and again we have the accelerating anode. That is the constituent of electron gun assembly. After that we have the deflection plate assembly, in which we have a pair of plates as a vertical deflection plates, and second one is a horizontal deflection plate. These will be the arrangement. So vertical deflection plates, these will be the two plates, pair of plates, and second pair of plates are called horizontal deflection plate. That will be the deflection plate assembly, and has a specific role that we discuss in the next slide here. Now the next part is of the fluorescence screen, and that will be the screen on which the electron beam is incident. So this will be the screen, and from that we observe the image or the waveform. So this will be the constituent of cathode ray tube, which has a number of components, small components. So let us go and discuss in detail about that particular tube. So cathode ray tube, CRT, is specially constructed vacuum tube which act as a visual indicator of electrical voltage. So this particular tube is a visual indicator of electrical volt. So voltage is observed as a visual indication. So the voltage will fluctuate the electron beam, and accordingly we have the visual effect. So that we are going to learn in the next slide. So what we have, the second point, CRTs may be used as an oscilloscope screen, a picture tube, a radar scope, or in many other applications. So we have CRT used in picture tube, oscilloscope, already we have to learn oscilloscope screen, and we have already discussed this picture tube of color television and black and white television. So that big screen, that glass part is called picture tube of black and white television or color television. So that is called picture tube. And third is a radar scope, in which we have to incident the waves and then reflection, and that we can found the particular position of either ship or aeroplane with the help of the radar system. In that also we use as a screen of radar scope or in many other applications. Now, what are the different components of CRT? So an electrostatically deflected CRT consists of, number first is already we have learned, the electron gun assembly, then second one deflection plate assembly, then third number fluorescent screen, and we have envelope in which all these particular components will be fixed. That is called glass envelope and base of the tube. So all this electron gun, deflection plate, fluorescent screen, all these are enclosed in a glass envelope. And then we have the connection for the tube as a base of tube. Okay. Now let's go in detail one by one. Electron gun assembly, which has the number of points. So what are the first points? What are the important points that we go through? The electron gun consists of heater or filament. So heater or filament. Filament already you know, in case of the ordinary bulb. So in that bulb we have the coil, and that coil will be get heated when current pass through that coil, and it will emit the light in case of ordinary filament bulb. So that filament type of arrangement or coil type of arrangement, that will be heat, and that heated part emit the electrons. So heater or filament, then we have cathode, then control grid, pre-accelerating anode, focusing anode, and accelerating anode. So this can be observed in the following figure. Check carefully, we have the figure of that electron gun assembly. So check carefully. So here we have the filament, and after that filament we have K means cathode. So cathode terminal, then control grid, this will be the arrangement of plates or cylindrical arrangement of these particular plates from which the electron can be controlled, that is called control grid. Then we have the first anode, that is called pre-accelerating anode. Then second one is a focusing anode, pair of plates, and then third will be the accelerating anode, that is in a form of spherical or cylindrical form. Cylindrically arrangement. So this is cross section of this particular electron gun system. So we have pre-accelerating anode and accelerating anode. These two will be connected to the positive supply, and with the help of resistance and rheostat, the focusing anode again we have connected to positive supply. Then we have cathode K and control grid, and these dashed lines represents the path of electrons or the electron beam, and here we have the screen. So these will be the components of the electron gun. Okay, now let us discuss what we have given the points. So second point, the heater heats the cylindrical cathode indirectly. The heater heats the cylindrical cathode indirectly means when we current will pass through that particular coil, the coil will be get heated, and when there is a heat, the electrons are emitted from that cathode. So electrons are emitted from cathode, the electrons that pass through the small hole in the grid form the beam current. So that electrons are accelerated. We know electrons are negatively charged particles, and that will be attracted towards the anode. Anode means positive terminal. So that electrons attracted towards the anode, and they form the beam, or number of electrons move in one direction, they will be give rise to the electron beam here. Now, number third point, the magnitude of beam current can be adjusted by intensity control. So we have one knob called intensity. So like volume button, we have the intensity control. With the help of that intensity control, we can change the magnitude, means number of electrons, which vary negative voltage of control grid with respect to cathode. So negative voltage given to the control grid, and that negative voltage limit the number of electrons that are going towards the control grid. So we can increase or decrease the amount of electron that is going in the direction of control grid or in a direction of anodes. So this will be the intensity button or knob, so that we can control amount of electrons. Now we have fourth point, the electron beam then pass through three types of anodes. Already we have shown in a diagram. First is pre-accelerating anode, then second focusing anode, and third one is the anode or the accelerating anode. So these anodes are cylindrical in form. So the shape of the anodes are cylindrical, and in which we have small hole or opening in the center of each cylinder. So the once again we have the diagram of that system. Take carefully, pre-accelerating anode, then focusing anode, and then accelerating anode. So these are the three parts or three anodes, and each having the specific role. Now check carefully the first part. So first anode is a pre-accelerating anode. So this will be accelerating, means electron are attracted toward that anode. So pre-accelerating means initial acceleration of electron toward that particular anode. Then second anode is focusing anode, means we have to focus the electron in particular point on screen, and for that we have the focus. So this similar to the lens system. In case of light, we have the phenomena of convergence and phenomena of divergence. So that accordingly we have the focus point. So that focusing is done with the help of focusing anode. So focus control can be used to vary the positive voltage on focusing anode, which control the sharpness of the display. So display sharpness depend upon the focusing anode or the voltage to the given to the focusing anode. Now number third anode is accelerating anode. The electrons are accelerated by high positive potential applied to two accelerating anodes. Therefore, a narrow and sharply focused beam is produced. The beam then goes to the deflection plate assembly. So here in electron gun, electron emitted from filament, then they attracted toward the pre-accelerating anode, focused by focusing anode, and then the again accelerating anode, and with the help of that system, the electron beam focus on particular point on screen. So this is the role of the electron gun. Now we have second part of the CRT, that is a deflection plate assembly. So these are the plates. There are two plates in deflection plate assembly. Now check carefully. Number first point is the electrostatically deflected CRT. There are two pair of deflection plate. Two pair. First pair in which two plates. Second pair, again we have two plates, and the arrangement of that plates, again we have the diagram. Check carefully. These plates, vertical plates means arranged in vertical, one above the another, and that plate is given certain potential in that particular plates. When potential is given, electric field is set up inside the plate. Suppose first plate is positive, second below lower plate is suppose negative, then electric field is set between positive plate to negative plate. That is a part of electrostatic, already we learn in physics also. When we have positive charge on one plate, negative charge on another plate, the electric field is running from, directed from positive to negative. So this electric field is acting between one plate to another plate. So this is called vertical deflection plate. So when electron enter into this vertical deflection plate, that plate will be deflect the electron and in vertical direction. Now we have the second horizontal deflection plate, so that will be aligned in this direction, so arrange in this particular direction. Now check carefully, the roll of this plate will be opposite. Check carefully. Second point, the plate which are placed vertically, check carefully, the plates which are placed vertically, one above the another, deflect the beam horizontally, therefore they are called horizontal deflection plate. Then second means plates are arranged vertically, they will be produce electric field, and accordingly these particular deflect the beam horizontal deflection plates. Then the plate which are placed horizontally deflect the beam vertically, therefore they are called as the vertical deflection plates. So these will be the pair of plates, horizontal deflection plates and vertical deflection plate, in the absence of any deflection voltage. When there is no voltage is given to plates on the deflection plate, the electron beam will strike at the center of the beam, center of the particular screen. So this will be without voltage, the electron beam will be incident at the center of the screen or the cathode ray tube. Now check carefully. Third part, fluorescent screen. So that will be the screen which is made from glass, and there is a coating, and that coating is called fluorescent. That is a material which glows. So check carefully, number first point, the narrow and sharply focused beam of electrons leaves the electron gun with a very high velocity and strike the screen. So electron incident on screen, so that screen will illuminate, means the screen will be produces light. When electron incident on the screen, that screen will be illuminates the light. So check carefully, the kinetic energy of traveling electron is converted into light emission. So kinetic energy of electron incident on screen, and that spot will be glow. When electron beam incident, that spot will be glow, and we view from other side, that spot will be look bright, like the pixel of the screen or LED or LCD screen. This screen has one point or pixel, and that pixel will be glow. That similar to that, we have the point on the screen that will be glow when electron strike on that particular point. So a spot is produced on screen, small light spot is produced on screen. Number third, on inner surface of screen, check carefully, inner surface of screen, inside the screen, a phosphor coating is present. So phosphor material is coating inside the screen, on which when electron incident, there is a glow. So this material has a property of the fluorescent. So that we are going to learn in the next part. Check carefully. So fourth point is, so check carefully, the phosphor coating is present. So that part we are going to once again study in the next topic also. So at that time we discuss in detail what are the properties of phosphor, which type of coating, what are the other materials that will be produced a glow in the screen, or small spot of light will be produced with the help of phosphor coating. So that topic we discuss in detail once again. Now we have the fourth point, glass envelope and base of the tube. Check carefully, number first, the envelope of CRT is made of glass and is highly evacuated. So envelope of CRT, so total envelope is made from glass. So glass will be covered that all the cathode ray, electron gun system, then particular deflection plates, all this particular setup is covered with the glass. So and that glass will be taken out, the air will be taken out, so we have highly evacuated, means inside the glass we have vacuum. So envelope of CRT is made of glass and is highly evacuated. Very heavy glass is used for face. So on the face that is called screen. Very thick glass will be used when electron incident with a very high velocity on that glass. Glass doesn't get crack or damage. So because of that, we use very high or thick glass will be used, heavy glass. So very heavy glass is used for the face of the tube. Now third point, the element of electron gun assembly are connected to pins on CRT base. Elements of electron gun assembly are connected to pins on CRT. So electron gun require the DC voltage, low DC voltage and high DC voltage, and for that we have number of pins will be required. That pins are given connected to the base. So the elements of the electron gun assembly are connected to pins of CRT base. So base has a number of pins. That pins will be go to the electron gun system as well as the pin. Some pins will be connected to deflection system also, in which vertical deflection and horizontal deflection system. Now we have number fourth, how much operating voltage inside the tube. The operating voltage of a CRT may vary from 500 to 33,000 volt. So very high voltage is produced inside the tube. So this 33,000 volt is DC, and that is useful for the deflection of electron beam in vertical direction as well as horizontal direction. So these are the four parts of the CRT. Now we have a detailed understanding of the electrostatic focusing. So electrostatic focusing or electron lens system is used in all CROs. So already we have shown this diagram. So first of all, we have the electron from cathode K will be emitted. Here we have filament, and from filament electron are continuously coming out, and that electron can be controlled with the help of control grid. We have given negative potential. So negative potential increase or decrease accordingly, number of electron from control grid will be controlled. Then first electron beam pass through pre-accelerating anode, and then pass through focusing anode, and then again pass through the second accelerating anode, and finally focus on screen at a fine point, and the point will be looks bright or glow. That glowing of that point will take place. So here we have equivalent to the lens system, first lens and second lens, with the help of focusing anode. Now again we have the connections, pre-accelerating anode and accelerating anode. These will be all, these focusing anode all will be in a shape of cylinder here, and small hole will be there inside. So these pre-accelerating anode and accelerating anode connected to high positive supply, and with the help of resistance and rheostat we have low voltage given to the focusing anode, and with the help of that the electric field is set up in between these plates, and that electric field work as the lens, either convex lens or concave lens. So the particular electric field work as the deflection lens, and that particular lens form the sharp image, a sharp point of electron beam at point C on screen. So check carefully, we have the following points. Three electrodes present in a system, the pre-accelerating anode, focusing anode and accelerating anode. Now there are three electrodes, already we know the three anodes. These electrodes are cylindrical in form, already we have shown here in a diagram, and coaxial with the CRT axis. So CRT axis, and in that axial that cylinders will be arranged. Focusing of electron beam is necessary to form a sharp image on the screen. So focusing of this particular electron beam is important to have sharp clear image on the screen. Now number third, the pre-accelerating and accelerating anodes are connected to high positive potential. So already we have shown in diagram, high positive potential is given to pre-accelerating and accelerating anode. The focusing anode is connected to lower positive potential. So low voltage, positive voltage is connected to focusing anode, and these system of anodes will form the electric field, and that electric field is given in number fourth point. The electric fields are created between anodes due to positive potential difference between the focusing and accelerating anodes. So the electric field is set up between the anodes due to potential difference between focusing and accelerating anodes, and that electric field is useful for focusing. Now check carefully number fifth point. The electron entering the electric field between pre-accelerating and focusing anode at angle other than normal to the equipotential surface will be refracted toward the normal. Now check carefully the fifth point. Suppose electron is traveling other than axis. So that electron having particular angle of incidence with the particular electric field, and if that certain angle, then with the help of that field the electron tend to move parallel to the axis. So when electron, this is suppose axis, and electron is moving other than the direction of axis, then with the help of electric field the electron turn the direction according to phenomena of refraction, and that electron beam parallel to the direction of electron beam. So electron entering the electric field between pre-accelerating and focusing anode, so first accelerating anode and focusing, at an angle other than normal due to equipotential surfaces will be refracted toward the normal. So electron beam directed toward the normal, and that direction is the direction of the axis of tube. Now number sixth point, therefore electron beam tend to become parallel to CRT axis. Check carefully, if electron traveling in other direction than direction of axis, then these electrons will be refracted and tend to move in direction of axis. Now check carefully what we have given in sixth point. These beam then enter the second concave lens. These beam then enter second concave lens. It is converged the focus, converged and focus on screen at center of CRT axis. Now second part, the beam enter the second concave lens. Second concave lens is, check carefully once again, we have diagram. This is suppose first beam concave lens and second concave lens. First concave lens tend to move, all the electrons are traveling in diverse direction, all the diverse direction electron will be move in parallel with each other. So these all electrons are parallel to each other. Now with the help of this electric field between focusing anode and accelerating anode, means second lens, and that second lens focus the electrons sharply on one point. So that is the role of two particular lens system. So what we have given in number sixth point, the beam then enter the second concave lens. It is converged and focused on the screen at the center of CRT axis. And number second, a front panel CRO mark focus. So front panel CRO, that photograph we have shown in the initial slide, we have one knob called focus, and that focus can set or adjusting that focus, the voltage on focusing anode will be vary, and therefore focal point of the beam can be moved along the CRT axis by changing the focus or focal length of the electron lens system. So this will be the part of electron focusing. Now we have the deflection system. So this deflection system in CRT, we have two parts. There are two types of deflection system can be used in CRT. The number one is called electrostatic deflection, and number second, magnetic deflection. So that we will learn in the next lecture. Till you can revise at home the initial part of this chapter is begin with the very first topic, that is CRT cathode ray tube, and for that you refer the Fadke publication, electronics Fadke publication. That textbook is very good compared to Supekar. Okay, so try, go through that textbook and try to understand the working. In short, we are going to write the working of all these particular components. So one by one, check the slide also, check the video in which we have a number of slides. Go through that particular slide, pause the video and note down the notes of that particular lecture. And try repeating that particular, repeating the video and observe carefully each and every point what we have explained here. Okay, thank you.